In one of my previous video, I introduced various ways to construct detector geometries in Geant4. GDML is one of them. I also compared GDML with other methods and commented on its advantages and disadvantages. If you decided to give it a try, this video is for you. GDML can be enabled in Geant4 if you have Xerces-C libraries and headers installed on your system. The latest Xerces-C library is only available in source code distributions, which means that you cannot download an installer to double-click. Instead, you will have to download the zipped source code, compile it in your system, and then install it. Allocate the just downloaded zip file in your file browser, right-click on it, select Extract All. In the pop-up dialog, delete the highlighted part and click Extract. Get into the extracted folder. You'll find the cmakelists.txt file along with the Xerces-C source code. As always, we launch CMake GUI from our start menu, drag the file into it, and create a build directory to store automatically generated files during the building process. Press Configure and click on Yes to confirm the creation of the build directory. CMake will also ask you to specify the generator for this project. Just click on Finish to accept the default option Visual Studio. If you don't have that option, you need to install Visual Studio before running CMake. After a successful configuration, you should be able to see many options showing up. One of them is called CMake Configuration Types. Leave only Release and delete all the others. Another option you may want to change is the install prefix. The default is in C program files. If you cannot write into this directory, you need to change it to another place. If you don't, you will run into a problem later. But I will provide a method to overcome that problem in a minute. Now, just press Generate and then Open Project. If you have only one version of Visual Studio installed on your system, you can just use it to open the automatically generated files. Otherwise, you can also let Microsoft to determine it for you. In the popped-up Visual Studio window, select Build and Build Solution, or simply press F7 to compile your Xerces-C. After a successful build, it's time to install the compiler libraries. This step is skipped by default. We need to do it manually by right-click on the install target and select Build. If you have chosen to install the libraries to disk C program files directory, this process will fail. As Visual Studio does not have the administrative privilege to do that, you need to quit Visual Studio and search for it in the Start menu, right-click on the icon, select Run as Administrator. In the Project Selection window, select the recently opened Xerces-C project. Now try to build the install target again by right-click on it and select Build. This time, you should be able to do it successfully. Open the Program Files folder in your file browser. To confirm that Xerces-C is installed there, the include directory contains headers, the lib directory contains libraries, and the bin directory contains executables and dynamically linked libraries. Now it's time to go back to the Geant4 compilation process and enable GDML there. If you don't know how to do this, please watch the tutorial indicated in the top right corner. Press Configure and you will encounter the following error saying that Xerces-C cannot be found by CMake for Geant4. The Geant4 installation guide provides a solution. You can use a CMake option called CMake prefix path to specify the location of Xerces-C. Let's try it out by clicking on the Add Entry button, type in the option name, and select the path to Xerces-C. Press OK to continue. Run Configure again. Check the box here to show advanced CMake options and search for Xerces-C here. You should be able to see that both the library and include directories are found by CMake. We don't need the debug library, so we can safely ignore this message. Now keep building your Geant4 as described in the tutorial shown in the top right corner. To verify that GDML is really enabled for your Geant4, let's try to compile an extended Geant4 example showing the usage of GDML G01. As always, drag the CMake list.txt file into your CMake GUI and create a build directory to store all automatically generated files for building. Choose Visual Studio as the generator. Click Configure, and you may run into error if you have not told Windows where your Geant4 is installed. Again, you can use the CMake prefix path to help CMake find Geant4, just as what we did to help Geant4 to find Xerces-C. But there is a better solution, that is to tell Windows where Xerces-C, Geant4, or any other libraries are installed through the path environment variable. Let me demonstrate the process. Search for env in your start menu, launch your control panel to edit the system environment variables. Click environment variables to continue. In the user variable list, select path, click edit. If you don't have this variable, click on new. Click new and then browse to add the Geant4 binary directory or bin directory in the list. You can use the same way to add Xerces-C or Qt bin directories here or any other third-party libraries bin directory here. Click OK to accept the new setup and OK to close the control panel. Now go back to configure our GDML example without adding the CMake prefix path. CMake should still be able to find Geant4 through the path environment variable we just set. Again, only select release as the configuration type. Right click on G01 and select build. There is no need to build all build or install targets, as we don't need to install the build example executables. After a successful build, you should be able to find a release folder in your build directory, where you can find the G01 executable, load GDML. Double click to run it. You may see an error message saying that Xerces-C dynamically linked libraries cannot be found. This is because we used CMake prefix path instead of the path environment variable to tell CMake where to find Xerces-C. CMake knows where Xerces-C is, but the operating system, or Windows, still does not know how. Again, we can modify the path environment variable and add the Xerces bin directory into it. Go back to the build directory that contains the release folder in your file browser. highlight the address bar and type in CMD and return. This will launch a Windows terminal where you can type in the executable release / load underscore gdml.exe space, and then followed by any GDML file in that folder and return to run it. At the end of the process, Geant4 will run a user interface to display the visualized geometry defined in the GDML file. It can be a Qt-based GUI or a native Windows GUI. This verifies that GDML is working for you. In case of Mac or Linux, the installation of Xerces-C is much easier, as they all provide pre-compiled libraries for you to install. You just need to run the right command according to your OS, and you are all set.